Hi, my name is Adeline and I'm a co-founder of Saturday Kids and Fab Cafe Singapore. So, in 33 years' time, most of the kids in Saturday Kids will be about 40, 50 years old. I think in 2050, a lot of the jobs that we see as being labeled as white collar or important will be kind of automated to machines. I think a lot of industries, especially the manufacturing industries, will see a lot of automation. I think a lot of the world's problems will be exacerbated. Things like climate change will definitely feel it more. Changes in technology or changes in what we think is possible will be happening at a faster pace. More people will be living in cities. Water sustainability will be a huge problem. I hope that, you know, people in the future will learn from what we've gone through. We're still in the early stages of, you know, this capitalism and technology, industrialization. I think by 2050, we would have gone through at least about 3 centuries worth of that and be able to understand like where things are actually going, how systems actually work. Yeah, I think so. I think it's already happening. I mean, you know, we get surgeries to enhance ourselves. We get surgeries to solve problems that we have with our teeth, with our hips, with our ACLs. And these are actually non-organic materials being included in our bodies already. Whether or not we're going to have like chips inserted into our body, that's a big question mark. I think the technology is heading in that direction. I think the ethical and the legal dimensions are still to be debated. And I think that part will be slowing the development of technology down. Eventually, yes, I can imagine people having chips inserted into their bodies or even little tattoo electronic stickers being put under the skin. I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. You know, if you can have like a little electronic sticker being stuck on your skin and kind of give, you know, people with diabetes some kind of reading every now and then to be able to like give them the right dose of medicine at the right time, I think why not? I would say there'll be more acceleration of whatever has happened. As to whether that includes peace, that's a big question mark. I think we're starting to see a lot of nation states and boundaries being stronger than ever. And I think a lot of the question of peace actually, you know, rests upon resources and also diplomatic actions taken by people. And so if there's going to be an increasing acceleration of production, increasing acceleration of things that people want, I think if resources are scarce, peace is going to be resting on shaky grounds. It feels a little bit like that. You have to change something different today so that tomorrow will be a bit different. And that's how I like to think about the future. If we don't change something today, tomorrow will be the exact same thing. And so, you know, we only live a life. You grow up, you come out of your, you know, you're born into this world and you have a limited time on Earth. And what you do with that time is going to be exceptionally important to yourself and to the people that you can actually impact. At the end of the day, you're going to die. So it doesn't matter how optimistic you think about the future, but it matters how much you can actually change the future and the people around you and make them feel better about their lives. I think if robots were to write history, if we were to conceive of a very, very intelligent machine that could write its own history or its own species history, I would like to think that they would portray a very utopic life where, you know, they are able to come out of the Gutenberg press. They are able to come out from a typewriter to something with a more haptic touch, like the iPad, for example. They would be able to help human beings, you know, translate their thoughts into more visual things. They would be able to help human beings translate their language into written documentation that can then have a longer legacy. That is a history from a standpoint of a machine. Whether I think that humans will have a dystopic future, I think the idea that humans and technology are in two different camps is it's a very narrow point of view. I like to think that the way that we understand our relationship with machines, there's no one camp, there's no one size fit all. As it is, you know, I'm sitting in front of two cameras. Is this machine going to help me? I don't know, but this machine is going to help me get my message across to other people who can then consume this message through the back of another screen. I think there are lots of people who feel like the rise of AI and the general all-purpose machine is going to take away all our jobs and, you know, make a lot of us unemployed, and then humans will be relegated to just like a floating head. I don't think that future is near at the moment. I think there's a lot of interesting things that can happen in between before we get to that stage. And also, I think a lot of it, the use of technology now, a lot of it is being used in developed countries to solve problems. And so a lot of it is optimization problems. I think a bulk of it has not been applied to problems being faced in developing countries. And I think that's what's most interesting, to be able to help developing countries get a foot up.